Chronic sleep loss can lead to a number of health problems. But first, let me define chronic sleep loss. Chronic sleep loss would be considered poor sleep, whether it be not enough sleep, too much sleep, or broken, choppy sleep, lasting for more nights during the week than not, and that spanning greater than 1 month. So that's just to give you a framework to go by. So if you normally sleep well, but once a month perhaps your child gets sick and you're up for 3 nights, that doesn't feel very good, but that's not considered chronic insomnia, especially when it comes to having these negative health effects, just so you know. Okay, so one negative outcome of poor sleep to your body is weight gain and diabetes. And studies have shown, and I have some study references in the notes so you can see the actual studies. So these studies show that chronic sleep deprivation leads to increased cortisol, and the increased cortisol affects the way your body processes sugar. And it's that defective sugar processing that can lead to insulin resistant and therefore diabetes. Now keep in mind, just to reiterate, this is chronic sleep deprivation and not a few nights here and there of poor sleep and suddenly you've got diabetes. So how does sleep deprivation make you gain weight? Well, part of it has to do with the impaired glucose processing, but a big part of it has to do with the impact sleep deprivation has on your appetite hormones. Ghrelin is the hunger hormone, and leptin is the satiety hormone, or the hormone that makes you feel full. Research has shown that just one night of sleep deprivation increases ghrelin, or increases your appetite, and decreases leptin, or decreases your sensation of being full. So the connection is that just that sleep deprivation reset your appetite such that you're hungrier and want to eat more, and even when you do eat, you don't feel as full. Some research has even linked the increased appetite in an increased craving for carbohydrate-rich foods, and this is exactly what the body would want, because leptin is mostly produced in the fat cells of the body, the adipose tissue, and if the levels are low, then the body is saying, or the fat cells are saying, we don't have enough fat. So let's hold off on breaking down some of that glucose and let's store it as fat, because our levels are low, guys, and we need this stuff around. So all the more reason that if you aren't sleeping enough and you're eating late, you can just pack on more fat. Now, if you are someone who sleeps 4 hours a night and you've been doing that pretty much for years, do I expect you to gain 50 pounds? Probably not, if you have a fairly slim body build. So it's not like it automatically means you pack on weight. You could, but doesn't have to mean that. What it could look like is that you gain weight over time, few pounds here, few pounds there, and despite changing your diet, despite exercise, you just can't seem to lose any weight. And you can see this with people who are in very good shape, people who bodybuild, things like that. If they're sleeping poorly, they can have trouble trimming down and losing particularly abdominal fat, having a hard time getting that six pack. Now, maybe you might not feel sorry for someone who can't get a six pack, but the point is that it doesn't have to manifest as packing on a bunch of weight. It could manifest as a gradual weight gain over time that you just can't seem to shake and can't seem to lose, even despite heroic efforts in changing your diet and exercising. Another negative consequence is cardiovascular disease. And this is thought to be influenced by that increased cortisol again, but also sleep deprivation causing an increase in other inflammatory type chemicals in the body that then accelerate hardening of the arteries. So through that you get then the cardiovascular disease, whether it be manifested as high blood pressure or simply increased risk of heart attacks because of that. In the reference materials, you'll see a reference to a study from the Journal of Cardiology that showed that people who slept too little or too much, so that greater than 10-hour thing, were at increased risk of having a shortened lifespan or sudden death. How that sudden death manifested, I'm not quite sure, but I think the net is poor sleep can be very bad, and even to the degree where we can look at it as a lifestyle marker for health. And then the last health effect I want to discuss is worsening of attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, or ADHD, or ADD even, as we sometimes call it. If you know someone or have a child or you yourself have ADHD, you'll know that it can be very debilitating and very problematic depending on the setting that you're in and how much what you do is stretching your ability to compensate for your attention issues. Well, add sleep deprivation to the mix and now you just accelerate the problem even more or exacerbate it even more. This can be seen even more dramatically in children with ADHD. So if you have a child who has an ADHD, or let's say it's marginal, it's a little bit of a problem, but your child's not on medication and they're just kind of getting by, you need to make sure your child gets sleep. It needs to be a huge priority to try to get your child to sleep enough, because their ADHD can be, the effect of it can be multiplied by them not sleeping.